It's been about 12 years since I put together a computer, and not only was it about time for a new one, but you can probably barely see it. That computer right back there in the corner, that one finally died. How long ago, guys? How long ago did that one die?
I don't know.
Okay, that one finally died.
Probably 6 months ago, maybe a little longer.
So, between needing a new one, and the kids want to play Fortnite, and it not running on a laptop, we've bought one new computer. It's not like we haven't ever bought any new computers in the last 12 years. We bought a laptop, and since I work in IT, I was able to bring home some older computers from work. So we've had
two computers that they're good for web browsing and email, and they can kind of sort of play some games. I think I could play Portal on them, but not good for Fortnite. So that's the reason why
the new computer parts have been ordered, and now we're gonna do the unboxing. And to help me with the unboxing is Nathan and Patrick. So let's get to it. All right, so here's our first box. I think this is the power supply, but we're going to find out. Who wants to do the honors?
Me.
Okay, I'm going to let Patrick do it first.
Yay.
Okay. Yep, this is our power supply. Got a 430 watt power supply because that's what the video card said it needed. Last system had, I looked it up last night or a couple nights ago, last system had a 600 watt power supply. This should be fine though. I don't plan on doing anything heavy duty. This will feed the video card. I just don't think the system's going to pull more than this amount. So this will work for us. It's a thermal take. They make good power supplies, so that's what we're going
to
use.
Alright, Nathan's going to open up the next box. There's probably multiple components in this box. Yeah, there you go. Patrick can help you.
Let's see.
Alright, we got our...
It's all wrapped up. We got our RAM. This is our RAM. Here, open that up for me. Okay. So this is our SSD drive. This is an M2 drive. This will give us really fast, speedy boot ups. I only got a 250 gig because that's really all I think I need. The RAM. Got 16 gigs, that should be enough for what we plan to do. And then this is the video card I ordered. Now this is not the, let's see, this is, got a GeForce GTX 1050. Thought it was the FTW, but maybe it was not. This is not, oh, duh, big letters right there, FTW. This is not the highest end video card I could have ordered. But again, it'll do for what we need.
All right, here's our next box. Motherboard that we got. This is it's a pretty good motherboard. It's a micro ATX. It only has one PCIe slot on it for the video, but it's got four slots for RAM. I ordered this motherboard because I don't need dual PCIe slots. Usually I order a motherboard with dual PCIe slots, and then, I can always upgrade and add another video card in the future if I want to. But I think the last two before this one, That's what I did. I always got them with dual PCIe slots, but never added another video card. So this time I decided, you know what? I'm probably never gonna want to add another video card. So I got this one. But what I will want, I probably will want to add more RAM. So that's why I got the four RAM slots on this board. And we'll show you all the details of all this stuff once we actually get it all opened. But yeah, this is a good budget motherboard. Here we have, well, this is our monitor. But
Patrick's gonna pull it out of the box.
There it is. You know, got the base, some video cables, power cable, manuals, monitors right down in there. We didn't necessarily need a new monitor, but let me show you our current monitor.
This is our current monitor.
It's not necessarily a bad monitor, but it's old and it was kind of a throwaway from work, and I just wanted something better, so that's why I ordered the Asus.
Now I'm sure that there's better monitors out there. Samsung, for example, makes really good monitors. Acer makes good monitors. There's lots of different monitor manufacturers. I got the Asus just because it kind of fit the price point I was looking for. Didn't really want to spend a whole lot of money on a monitor, but I wanted something better than what we have. The one that we have, again, right back there, it's starting to show a little bit of what I call ghosting from time to time, where the images will kind of duplicate a little. You'll see a kind of a shadow of an image. So I just didn't like it. Wanted to get something new.
Now it's time for our last box. You can probably tell from the box itself, it's a Cooler Master.
It's a case. It's the tower.
Why don't we let Nathan...
I'm going to let Nathan open it up. Okay, Nathan, you think you can do it? This right here, this is really the reason why I don't buy computers pre-built. I don't like modern cases. In fact, here, let's... This case is the main reason why I don't buy pre-built computers. Hello, Nathan. They had a PC, a Dell XPS at Costco. That was probably maybe $100, $150 more than when it was on sale than what I put together. But I really don't like the XPS cases at all. They're fine cases, they look really nice, but I prefer, here, help me take this off. Just this top part.
Here.
I prefer, turn it over. Come on, turn it over. There we go. Careful, don't scratch the floor. I prefer cases that where you can see the drive. You can see the drive bay here, and there's the ports are all in the front, like this one has. Go ahead, lay down. You don't have to hold it. Don't lay down. And I am I'm a lazy person. I like to put stuff on the top of the case. I like to be able to put papers there, maybe a coffee cup. Recommend that just because there's a big old giant vent right here, and if the coffee spills, then bye bye computer. But yeah, I do not like the Dell XPS cases. They're fine for at work. We have a couple of them at work. They do a really good job. The specs are decent, but at home I like to build my own PCs. I like to put everything together. The only time we don't do that is when we're buying laptops, and that's mostly, you can't do that with a laptop. So usually what we do with a laptop is I will look around at two or three different manufacturers and find the one with the specs that I think is the best for the best price. So anyway, there's our case. That's the end of it, and I think the next video will be us putting everything together. So hit subscribe if you liked the video. Hit like. Give us a thumbs up if you liked the video. comment below if you have anything that you want to add or say or tell us. You know, tell us that we bought crappy components if you want. Tell us you like the components if you want. Give us some feedback. I'll leave the parts list down below in the description. Nathan's given the thumbs up. Nathan likes the video. As I was saying, I'll put the parts list in the description. And you know, if you're looking for a new computer, you know, it's kind of what I do. You can either build one off the based on the parts list, or you can message me. You can hit me up, and I'll see what I can do to help you out. We'll see you in the next one.
All right, quick update before continue and start setting up the monitor and all the rest of the components. Looks like when I placed the order for everything, even though I did add all to cart, like you can do on Newegg, the processor didn't get ordered. Processor's
pretty important part of the computer.
It's not gonna boot without that. So I'm just not gonna even try to put everything together right now. My guess is that the processor wasn't in stock, and I just didn't see that it wasn't listed. So I was just looking through everything, no processor. I looked at the order, no processor. So we're just gonna have to do the build on another day. I'll have to do the build later. See you in the next one.